Hey everybody, it's Ingrid from Twinkl, and today we're talking about bar charts. In case you're wondering, a bar chart organizes information or data into a graph using bars of different lengths. The length of these bars is proportional to the amount of information they represent. For example, here is a vertical bar graph showing the popularity of different colors among a group of children. As you can see, the names of the colors are written along the bottom, and a sequence of numbers labeled children are written along the left-hand side. The colors written along the bottom are categories, but may also be referred to as categorical variables. The numbers along the side represent the value of the category. In this case, how many children have said they like each color. To read a bar chart, consider the length of a bar connected to each category to find its value. If you wanted to know how many children chose pink as their favorite color, you would look at the number that lines up with the bar labeled pink on the vertical axis. In this case, 6. If a bar does not line up with a number but falls in a gap, the value would be the number that falls between the two numbers given. In our example, there are 5 children who chose green because the bar aligns with the gap between 4 and 6. So do all bar charts look like this? No. There are a few different ways data can be organized in a bar chart. Let's go through some of them briefly. Our previous example was a vertical bar chart, but you can also get horizontal bar charts. These are pretty much exactly the same, just lying on their side. Maybe our bar chart got a little sleepy and wanted to lie down for a bit. Or maybe a horizontal bar chart would just fill the space in your document better. You can also get grouped bar charts. Sometimes when you're making a bar chart, you may realize that the information cannot only be separated into categories, but into groups within them. In this example, we are still looking at the popularity of different colors, our categories, but have also grouped them into broad age groups depending on their year of schooling. This is handy because it gives us more information. The biggest advantage of grouped bar charts is they don't only help us compare the categories, but groups within them as well. You can also get stacked bar charts. These are pretty much exactly the same as grouped bar charts, except instead of the bars sitting neatly next to each other, they're stacked on top of each other. This is helpful because each stack represents one whole, so you don't need to do any adding up to figure out its value. Like in our example, you can easily just look at it and tell that there were 15 children who were polled in each age group. Boom, too easy. You can also get clustered stacked bar charts. This is a mix of a grouped bar chart and a stacked bar chart because we're taking stacks and grouping them together. Just like in this example, this lets you break down the data even further. Like here, we are not only comparing favorite colors among age groups, but also schools. So I get that seeing all these different kinds of bar charts can be a little overwhelming, but it's handy to know because when you're deciding what kind of bar chart you want to use to represent your data, you can think about your goal and what you're trying to achieve and then choose the most appropriate one. Overall, there are many reasons why we might use bar charts to organize our data. One reason is that it makes it really easy to compare our different categories. Looking at some of our earlier examples, you can see right away that yellow is a very popular color, because it has the highest number of children liking it. They also make it easier to see trends and patterns in data. If a value of a category is growing or shrinking, this is called a trend. A pattern is something that seems to keep happening. Laying out this data so you can interpret your patterns and trends is one of the benefits of bar charts. Luckily, Twinkl has a great range of educational resources for learning about bar graphs. For instance, these differentiated worksheets have activities that give learners practice making bar charts using given data. The activities build on each other to ease you in, so you can go from completing a partially completed bar chart to making your own from scratch. And as I mentioned, they are differentiated, so learners can have a go at the option that suits them and challenges them appropriately. Of course, there are plenty of other helpful materials available on the Twinkl website, so make sure you have a browse and see what's out there. That's all for now, but thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a lovely day.